I don't make friends easily. I know plenty of people, but I don't let most of them close.
Here we go again. Better get ready to run. Be in trouble. Better hurry. Emma!
Guys,
coming!
Something bad was gonna happen to me?
This is not the bad thing! Keep your head down! It's safe now.
I got a really bad feeling about all of this.
I'm gonna need those keys to the diner now. There's a motel key there that I have to get.
Oh, hey, you don't have to do that. I have the motel master key. I work for the same company, you know. What's at the motel?
Well, there's a dead guy. He's got something I need to get into the Mount Redtooth Observatory.
God, that's awful. Hey, you wanted to know about the guy who looked like you, didn't you?
The last time you said he had a party, but you didn't go.
No, that's not true. I did go. It was really great at first, and then I didn't see it myself, but I hear he turned nasty. He hurt a bunch of guys pretty bad, and there was this girl. She died. But I didn't hear about that until afterwards. I thought that he was so charming.
And then he went to the diner.
That's right. I wasn't involved. I wasn't involved with that at all. I don't know what happened.
Fine. I need to check out these motel rooms. In the meantime, you stay here, okay? I'm serious. Keep the lights on and stay here.
Yeah, okay. You got it. I sure hope you're right about this.
You're gonna stay here this time, right?
Because the last time I didn't and that thing, whatever it is, happened to me.
Yeah. I don't want you to get hurt again.
Don't worry, I'm gonna stay put. I don't remember what happened exactly, but I learned my lesson.
Good. It doesn't have to happen exactly the same way this time around. You proved that much when you went out and got those things for me. I think you're gonna be okay.
Let's hope you're right.
Sloane and fills her with dread. This time, she does as she's told. It's not enough to save her.
Alice and Barry.
It's said that nobody knows what the future might bring, but for this man, it's no longer entirely true. A weaker man might simply give up, but the champion of light is an expert on destiny. Sometimes the puppet and puppeteer can be one and the same. Mount Redtooth, its top littered with man-made eyes that stare into the endless depths of space. Tonight, the Champion of Light will depend on them to pick out a message from the ether. As history repeats itself, the man remembers the patterns. He knows that he needs the missing part for the telescope.
I'm gonna find Dr. Meadow's car. That's where the camera should be. As a storyteller, my first real... There are places where our world is... I've seen the enemy. The darkness rose from the depths of... Stories come naturally to us. We can't help it. There are many different worlds, many...
It's you! How dare you! No, wait. It isn't you, is it? I suppose you'd better come in. I'll unlock the door.
Thanks!
You'll have to forgive me, but this feels very strange. It seems like this has all happened before.
I have the replacement part for your telescope, Doctor.
All right. Let's get it installed.
Yet. There's a problem with the cooling system.
Yes, that's right. I remember. All right, let me think. If they're sabotaging it, they'll be at the primary coolant pipe outside. If you can secure it, we should be ready to pick up the signal. That is why you're here, isn't it?
Yes, it is. I'll take care of it.
Before you go, if you have the time, I'd appreciate if you came up here and explained a few things. All of this is very strange to me.
I don't know what's going on, but I seem to remember having had this encounter before.
It's not deja vu, Doctor. This has happened before. We're caught in a time loop.
That's utterly insane. How could that be?
I can't really explain it. I suppose I could call it magic.
I don't believe in magic.
Neither do I, but I can't argue with what I've experienced. Listen, what matters now is the signal. The last time we only caught a part of it. I need the rest of it. Whether you believe me or not, you want to look into this as much as I do, right?
Yes. All right.
I realize that you have trouble believing this.
That's an understatement. I can't deny that what you say resonates with me on some level I don't pretend to understand. But for all I know, I'm simply delusional.
But it's not just you. I've experienced the same thing as you. Doesn't that prove something, at least?
Maybe. On the other hand, given your appearance, and the fact that you're trying to convince me that I'm not insane, perhaps you're merely a hallucination that accompanies my delusions.
You're not having a psychotic episode, Doctor. For what it's worth, I'm a skeptic by nature. I completely understand your reluctance to believe me.
There are people caught so deep in their psychosis that they retroactively manufacture memories and beliefs that conform to the situation at hand.
Sure, but you have to stop second-guessing yourself at some point, if you want to get something done. Thank you.